Hello students, this is Mrs. Miller, and the purpose of this video is to provide direct instruction on plot, setting, and character. Now, you should have note-taking page 8 in front of you right now, and you can push pause on the video as many times as you need in order to fill in the notes. Now, I'm taking my information from page 28 in the 7th grade textbook. That's what I used to put this video together. So if you need to go into the book and look at the page, the specific page, then you are welcome to do that. Let's begin by talking about setting. Setting is the time and place of the action. An example of time would be a historical era, a season, or a time of day. I'm thinking back to our story exploring the Titanic, and I think about the time of that story, the historical era. It was April 14th, 1912. A specific time of day might be 10 o'clock a.m., and a specific season might be a cold spring evening. So this is all part of the setting of exploring the Titanic. Another example of setting is a country, a neighborhood, or a room. Again, I'm thinking about the setting for exploring the Titanic, and a particular setting is aboard the Titanic. Here's a picture of one of the rooms in the Titanic, and then also it took place in the Atlantic Ocean. So that is all part of the setting. Let's move on to characters. The characters are the people, animals, or imaginary creatures that take part in the story. For example, Frederick Fleet, who was one of the lookouts, Reginald Lee, who was another lookout, Captain John Smith, and then Jack Phillips and Harold Bride, the two wireless operators. Those are all some of the characters in the story exploring the Titanic, and their behavior affects what happens in the story. So that's their role. However they behave, that's what affects what happens in the story. Think about for a moment the actions of Jack Phillips. Jack Phillips responded very rudely to the operator from the Californian who sent him the iceberg warning, and that had a tremendous effect on what happened in the story. Because of Phillips' response, the final message was not delivered to the captain. The operator of the Californian turned off his radio, and then the Titanic was not able to reach out to the Californian and ask for help. So the behavior of the characters in a story affects what happens later in the story. Now let's talk about the plot. The plot is the series of events in a story. In other words, the plot is the stuff that happens. Take a look at these pictures from the exploring the Titanic. That's when people were boarding the ship. Then we had the iceberg warnings. Then the ship hit the iceberg. The ship started to sink. The ship sank even more. And then the Carpathia came and rescued their survivors. So that is what the plot is. The plot is the stuff that happens in the story. Now the plot is built around something called conflict. A conflict is a struggle between forces. And there are two types of conflict in a story. There's external conflict and internal conflict. Let's take a look at external conflict first. The Latin root ex means out or from, and you could see that the word external starts with ex right here. Let's think about some other words that have this root. I see the word exclude, which means to leave out. If you exclude somebody from your group, you leave them out of your group. And the word exclaim. Exclaim is when you cry out. Okay. Now, external conflict is a struggle that happens outside of one's self. The struggle is with an outside force. The force may be another character, a group of characters, or with nature. Let's look at an example from exploring the Titanic. Captain Smith attempted to safely navigate the Titanic across the Atlantic Ocean, but he had no way of getting around the iceberg and avoiding the sinking of the ship. So this is a character versus nature conflict. You can see Captain Smith versus the iceberg. An iceberg is something in nature, and the iceberg is something outside of Captain Smith. So that is an external conflict. Let's take a look at internal conflict. The Latin root in means in or on. Let's think about some other words that have the root in. We have inside, which is within. And then the word income, which is the money that someone earns, it's the money that's coming into them. So an internal conflict is a struggle within a character's mind. The character must deal with opposing thoughts or feelings and usually has to make some sort of decision. Let's take a look at an example from Exploring the Titanic. As Ruth Becker's mother lay in bed, she had a feeling that something was wrong with the ship. She had to decide if she would remain in her room or go and investigate the sudden change aboard the Titanic. So this is a picture of, I pulled this picture off the internet, it's supposed to be Ruth Becker's mom. And she had a decision that she had to make, so that was with her mind. And that decision was based on a feeling that she had, a feeling within her heart. So that conflict was inside of her head, okay? Okay, now that we've gone through our notes, you have a task. Your task is to read Preparedness 101, Zombie Pandemic on the Internet. You also need to complete the Preparedness 101 graphic organizer that's on the back side of your note-taking page. I've also made the graphic organizer available to you in the online class. This will show your understanding of characters, setting, plot, and conflict. Let me click on the link to show you what you should see. Now, here is what the Preparedness 101 Zombie Pandemic graphic novel looks like. So what you're going to do is you're going to go through the story and you're going to read it. Okay, this is a very colorful graphic novel and I hope that you will enjoy it. Okay, you're going to be doing an assignment over this story in Mrs. Stanley's class. So we're first reading it in my class so that you can know what the story is all about. So you're going to read through the story and you're going to pause as you need to and you're going to fill in this graphic organizer. This is for the zombie pandemic. You'll fill in the characters. You'll tell me the setting of the story. You'll tell me the plot. That's the series of events in the story. You'll give me one example of external conflict, and you'll give me one example of internal conflict. Unfortunately, this story is not available in the classroom. It's only available on the internet. So you need to make sure that you read the story, and you will have a test over this story in reading class. And like I said earlier, you'll have an assignment for Mrs. Stanley involving this story.